हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फोर्ट्रॉन एकेडमी। माय नेम इज हर्षवर्ध्स एंड टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग अवर वीडियो ऑन 16 एसेंशियल टर्म्स यू मस्ट नो टू लर्न वीबीए प्रोग्रामिंग पार्ट टू। इन द पार्ट वन ऑफ द वीडियो ऑफ 16 एसेंशियल टर्म यू मस्ट नो टू लर्न वीबीए प्रोग्रामिंग वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज वीबीए, व्हाट इज वीबीए कोड, हाउ वीबीए कोड इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द मैक्रो, व्हाट इज मैक Macro, what is statement, what is module, what is classes, what are the objects, and all things are covered in the part one of this video. So this video is the continuing of that part, and we will now talk about the point to be discussed in the part two video. The point in the part two video, we will discuss about what are the collections, how the objects related to each other. Thirdly, we will talk about what is property. In the fourth point, we will talk about what are the methods. Fifth, we will talk about how do properties and methods look like in Excel. In the sixth point, we will talk about what are variables and arrays. In the seventh point, we will talk about what is condition. And in the eighth point and end of the video, we will talk about what is loop. And in the end, we will give it the video with a conclusion. Now let's move forward and talk. Now we will move on to the ninth point, and we will talk about what are collections. In Visual Basic for Application, the word collections refer to collections of objects. In my previous video, I have told you about the objects. What are the objects? What is consist of? How the object and classes are different? And if you want to learn more, you can go to my previous video and see the points. And now we will move on to the collection of object, that is collection itself. At the basic level, the general use of the word collection does not differ too much from the use given to it in VBA. As you would expect, in very general term, a collection is a group of objects, more precisely a group of related objects. Therefore, you can use collections to group and manage objects that are related between them. At the basic level, the concept of collection is relatively simple, but if you want a more graphical representation or illustration, you can check out the Dr. Zeus collection. So you can see there that what is the concept of collection and how the graphical representation of collection look like. So in the context of VBA, collections are objects. There is also a collection of class. If the collection group objects that have something relationship between them, you may be wondering what are they called. Now we will move on to the 10th point, that is how the objects related to each other. Objects can be related to each other in several ways. However, the main type of relationship is of containment. Right? Again, I will repeat how the objects are related to each other. The main type of relationship between objects is containment. Containment relationships are present when the objects are put within a container object. Like in my previous video, I have gave you an example of containers in a port, in which each container has some goods. So when two objects are put into the one container, since that would resultant into a containment relationship. This means that objects that contain other objects within them, such as a plastic container that hold the Dr. Zeus book in the image. So those are called the containment relationship. A very good example of containment relationship is a collection of objects. Another important type of relationship is hierarchical, which is mostly applicable to classes. Hierarchical relationship occur when a class is derived from a more fundamental class. So you can understand if there is hierarchy between a class, it is called hierarchical relationship. But in case of object, the type of relationship is called containment relationship. Now we will move forward on to the 11th point, and in which we will discuss what is property. So each object have properties. Like each thing has certain properties to represent itself, then also, and in our case, the object also have properties. These are the attribute, characteristics or qualities that can be described the object. I cover the topic in this Excel tutorial. So VBA allows you to do both the followings: read the current value of the object properties and change an object properties. Let's take for example this horse. What are some of its properties? How about color of its hair and its eyes, the size of its ears? So you can see this horse and take for example and you think of what are its properties. You get an idea that it runs, it sees, it take oxygen, it breathe out carbon dioxide, it runs, it eats and everything. Just by looking at something that is object, like you can say horse is an object, and what are its property? So the characteristics that represent that object is called properties. In addition to having properties, object have method. As you may expect, the next question I answer is what is method, which is the 12th point. Now, what are the methods? To understand what method are, let's go back to English grammar. As I explained above, when defining the term object, an object has something done to it, right? The method is something which is done to the object. Like when something like, for example, in other words, a method express an action performed with or on an object. In grammatical terms, a method in VBA is roughly an equivalent of a verb in English. I cover the topic in detail into my next videos and more. Let's continue using the horse to illustrate the meaning of this visual basic for application component. What is the example of a method that could be applied to a horse? What about and how about horseback riding? Like in my previous videos, I have told you, in my previous slide, I have told you properties about horse. Like, let us give a complete representation now. Now, horse is object. Now, if I want to know about properties, I have told you about the description of a horse. You may know from that what are my object and what is its property. Now, I ride a horse. That is the method of it. So this is the method. I hope the complete understanding by giving an example of a horse will clear your concept regarding object, methods, properties, collection, classes and everything. Now after this we will move on to the 13th point of our video. How does the properties and method look like in Excel? Now let's go back to best Excel tutorial macro that I have been using as an example in a particular guide for beginners. If you run that macro, Excel does the following. Types the best, this is the best Excel tutorial in the active cell. So like if you see this GIF, I have put this GIF in my PowerPoint slide. You can see I have put this red block in which I have put this is the best Excel tutorial. Auto fits the column width of the active cells, colors the active red, changes the font color of the active cell to blue. Now that you know that what is property and what is method, would you be able to distinguish which of the above make a reference to a property and which to a method? To answer this question, let us look again at our VBA code. At the right lower part of our screen, we have a VBA code. Now to answer this question, let us take a look again at our VBA code, which is at the right side lower part of our screen. Now let's take a closer look at our relevant lines to determine whether they make a reference to a property or a method. Active cell formula R1C1. This is a best Excel formula, Excel tutorial. This line tells Excel to write. This is the best Excel tutorial in Active Cell. Active Cell returns an object. More precisely, it returns the current Active Cell. So what is formula R1C1? A property or method? So correctly, this is more precisely a property. R1C1 sets a formula for Active Cells. So what are the method now? So method is like autofit. So this is the difference between properties and method. Now we will move on to the 14th point of our video, that is, what are the variable and arrays. So variable is one of the most important thing in a VBA code. You must know about the variable and array. In computer science, a variable is a storage location that you pair with a name and use to represent a particular value. That value is stored in computer's memory. In another word, you use variables as placeholder for particular values. You can think about variable as an envelope. So for example, you have a lot of envelopes and each envelope has a particular information, and each envelope within itself contains a letter. You can say a variable that is a contains a storage information. So variables that contain a single value are known as a scalar variables. You use scalar variables when working with a single item. What do you do if you are working with a group of items that are related to each other? In these cases, you use arrays. Arrays are set of indexed elements that share the same data type and have a logical relationship between them. The function is substantially the same as that of variable, holding values. The main difference is that array can store several values, while scalar variable can only hold one. That means variable hold one value, while a set of variable that has a relationship in between them are called arrays. So variable makes an array, while variable in itself is a scalar variable. For example, if you do something in a data, then you have like certain relationship within a column that you gave an index and typed it in a header it as a date, time, or total cost and something like that, and the whole column will become an array, while within that each cell has a variable in itself, and the combination and giving the relationship in between those variables called them an array by combining it with a logical relationship. Now we will move on to the 15th point of our video, that is, what is condition. A condition is a statement or expression that evaluates to either true or false. Then depending on whether the statement has evaluated to true or false, Excel executes or does not execute a group of statements. In other words, if the condition is met true, something happens, and if it does not met its inclusion criteria or exclusion criteria, then it will resultant into something not happening. So a condition is a statement. Like, can you think of a way you can apply a conditional statement in a VBA application you are developing to keep track of how many sugar cubes you are given to your host by caretaker? Or certainly other examples you can also look, like example, if I have given 100 rupees to certain salesmen, what are my comebacks and what are my interests and all those things. If it happens, if the person gives you back, then you can take a percentage and calculate what are the interest you got. And if doesn't get returned, if the money doesn't come back to you, the condition make itself false and something will not happen, the calculation won't be done. So hint, conditional statement often use the if and then structure. So if you know in an Excel how to put an if formula, you can easily conclude a condition. Now in the end and in the last point of our 16 ways to understand and 16 essential terms to know about the VBA programming, the last point is, what is loop? Loop are the statements that are specified once but are carried out several times. Like if I put something in a loop, like if you put a song in a loop, it will play itself again, again, and again, and again. So that is a loop. In other words, a loop is a particular statement that make a group of instruction be followed multiple times, just like conditional statement. There are several ways in which you can structure loop. However, for the purpose whole sugar cube application, you can use for each next statement. This statement asks Excel to execute a group of statements repeatedly for each of the component of a particular group. Like if you get a total of jan Feb, March, and each and everything. And you want to Excel to add each and everything itself. Then you put everything in a loop structure. Then it adds Jan to Feb, Feb to March, March to April, April to June, and in the end, total to total, with the year to year, with the quarter to quarter, with a decimal year to decimal year, and everything like a decade to decade, and it's starting on adding up. It depends on what you give a structure for loop. Now we will move on to the end of our video, in which we will give a conclusion. You have made it to the end of this Excel VBA tutorial for beginners. By now, based on what you have learned on this beginner's guide, you know the meaning of at least 16 essential terms you need to know to learn VBA programming. You are also able to understand how some of these terms are sometimes used interchangeably and some of the discussion regarding their use. Additionally, you have seen how this concept come together to form a macro, and you know how some of the VBA components that you have explained in this Excel VBA tutorial for beginner can be implemented in practice. I hope that this Excel tutorial for beginners have proved that the most essential terms you need to know to learn VBA programming are not that complicated to understand. You are likely to find the terms that have been covered in this guide for beginners many times during your journey to be becoming a VBA expert. So you want to save this video and come back as required during your future Visual Basic for application studies. So with this point, I am going to end this video, and I hope you all queries have been cleared. And if not, kindly write us in comment section and we will surely get back to you. And if this video helps in any way, kindly drop us a like and don't forget to subscribe our channel for amazing videos in future. Till then, have an amazing and good day.